As the lights come off and on, in response to motion in the empty galleries, we're keeping a good eye on the pictures. And although they may be a bit lonely, they're fine. Even in lockdown, we're keeping a close eye on the collection. That's by looking at the pictures on the wall, close inspections, and also we monitor the environmental conditions, working with the building department to make sure that standards of temperature and humidity and light exposure are maintained just as they are during opening times. I'm speaking to you from one of the conservation studios at the National Gallery, and although we are coming in to do essential work during the pandemic, it's a lower level of activity than is normal. Nonetheless, it's one of the more notable and enjoyable features of conservation studios is they have the most amazing juxtapositions of different kinds of work from different periods. So here we are, I'm talking to you today about the Rubens, but if I spin around, rather typical mix in any conservation studio of northern, southern, 19th century, Italian, Flemish. In fact, just happens to be what's here at the moment, Renaissance works. Very bad camera operation. It's all here. Here you can see the great Rubens head Steen during retouching, well along in its treatment, while next to it we have a Van Dyck during cleaning, and you can see already the difference in the varnish where it's thinned or reduced on the left and not yet removed on the right of her face. This is the great Piazzetta, the unfinished Piazzetta of Abraham and Isaac, which you may know from an earlier video made during cleaning. The cleaning's finished now, and we've started doing the filling of the many, many tiny losses. It looks probably a bit daunting now because they're all so bright and white, but actually the image is very, very well preserved. And although these losses are numerous, they're all very small. And as soon as they have the ground color, that wonderful reddish brick brown color that will be applied to these white losses, immediately you'll see the image take force again, and it'll be quite thrilling, I think, to bring this picture back together again. So our approach to retouching small-scale damages, or relatively small-scale damages, is to make them look invisible to the viewer, the casual viewer in the gallery, because as you can imagine, doing something where you can see the retouching in an area like that split, which in fact goes right along the horizon line further along the picture as we move across, would really be very distracting to the way you read the picture, and we want to kind of be out of the way. We don't want any sense of our work to be intruding upon your enjoyment of the painting. We want our work to unlock what's there and allow you to see it and appreciate Rubens most fully without the distraction of knowing about the modern restoration. The fact that we do all of our retouchings on top of the varnish that we apply to the picture means that they show very easily in ultraviolet light. You can see them as generally bluish black dark shapes, and it's very, very easy then to identify just what kind of retouching has been done in the modern restoration.